up? It's Greg Tepper of Dave Campbell's Texas Football and TexasFootball.com here at the Fox Sports Southwest Studios. Oh my gosh. It's the Emmy Award-winning producer of High School Scoreboard Live, Patrick Madurovsky. We're getting ready for High School Scoreboard Live. Do you need something?
No, no. Okay. Please.
There's we on TV?
There's Rick Renner. This is already going terrible. And there's Craig Way. I'm just trying to do an instant reaction video. I'm just trying to do an instant reaction video to the stuff that happened on Saturday, guys. So we'll go like we did last night. We'll go game by game, some kind of rapid fire responses. Lake Travis over Judson, 48-35. Judson was in control of this game early and actually dominated the first half of it. But Lake Travis came back in that second half and was spectacular. Hudson Card comes back, and this is an offense that can certainly use a guy like that. They have been really good, and we just have to start wondering if Lake Travis has Judson's number. Katie Taylor over Cy Creek is really impressive. That was always kind of an odd regional final, but what a job by Katie Taylor. A dominating effort, 58-20 over Cy Creek. They are through to the state semifinals, where they will draw 6A Division 2, Region 3. Oh, that's right. They're drawing, who's that?
Westlake,
thank you. Austin Westlake, who won last night. Thank you. Sorry, that's the 1-6A game from last night. Okay. Spring Westfield takes down Dallas Jesuit in a close one, 38-28. The Westfield defense does the job. They force a number of turnovers against ending the kind of the Cinderella story for Jesuit. I felt like whenever Longview went down, the second best team in that region was probably Westfield. Feels like they are the team to beat, and certainly deserving winners of Region 2, where they will meet Denton Geyer, who was one of the more impressive winners today. 48-7 over Amarillo Tascosa. The 48, that's fine. We kind of expected that. We know Eli Stowers and company were going to cook offensively. But to hold that Tascosa offense to 7 points is a chore, and that was really impressive by the Geyer defense. Duncanville beats South Lake Carroll 49-35 in a game that Duncanville kind of held South Lake Carroll at arm's length for the majority of this game. The offense started to get going, and that's something that's impressive. I have honestly not been super impressed by the Duncanville offense this year, at least maybe compared to the impossible bar they set last year. This was more like it. That offense started really cooking. And then Galena Park North Shore beats Umbola Atascocita 76-49. That's the most points ever scored in a state semifinal game. They ring up 804 yards of total offense on Atascocita, and a good Atascocita defense. Wow, is all I can say. And suddenly, 6A Division 1 is looking like the champs are not going anywhere, at least for now. Rockwall beats Prosper 59-42. Jackson Smith Ojigba goes nuts. I think he had 5 touchdowns in this game. He's inching ever closer to becoming the state's career receiving yards leader. 5A Division 1, Denton Ryan makes short work of Colleyville Heritage, 56-10. That machine is getting churning. We always felt like they were the favorite in Region 1, but now comes the big test where they will get a date with Frisco Lone Star next week. And, you know, this Ryan team has been great. This is going to be their biggest test to date whenever they take on Frisco Lone Star next week. Shadow Creek takes down Manor. Great story for Manor to get to this point, but Shadow Creek just too much. Kyron Drones, spectacular in this game. Defense took away from Manor, and this was an impressive win by the Sharks, who are through to the regional final, or rather the state semifinal. Still one game in action right now as I'm recording this. Bernie Champion is up on Corpus Christi Cal Allen, 41-35, kind of late in the fourth, but I got to record this because we got to get on to High School Scoreboard Live. So kind of we'll see. I took Cal Allen in that game, but Bernie Champion's offense has been excellent so far. And so my question is, can Cal Allen find a stop? We'll find out. This may be a dumb video. Although it probably already is. Fort Bend Marshall over Manville, 40-10, avenging their regular season loss. This was all about the Fort Bend Marshall defense. The Fort Bend Marshall defense showed up and played their best game of the season, and that is what it's going to take going forward. A fantastic, fantastic win for Fort Bend Marshall, avenging their regular season loss. They are through where they will await either Cal Allen or Champion in the state semifinals. And then one 4A Division 1 game, Lampasas, 49-34 winners over Liberty Hill. Liberty Hill, of course, one of those, I guess you'd call them a Cinderella story, even though they were a finalist last year, but they've snuck into the playoffs. The road ends here at the hands of Ace Whitehead, the quarterback there for Lampasas. And what can we say that hasn't already been said? He put on an absolute clinic in this game. That Lampasas offense is going to be great. By the way, Carthage, Lampasas next week. Oh my gosh. And there was one 1A game that we actually accidentally filed on the wrong date in at texasfootball.com/scores. But McLean wins a wild one, 97-81 over Rankin to punch their ticket back to the AT&T Stadium. They will draw Blum in the 1A Division 1 state championship game, 11 a.m. next Wednesday at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Once again, huge game from Ben Crockett. Defense, you know, got pushed by this Rankin team, but this was power versus speed, and power for McLean ended up winning out. So that's all my thoughts on Saturday games across the regional finals of the Texas High School Football Playoffs. TexasFootball.com/playoffs has all your coverage for all things Texas High School Football Playoffs. And of course, watch High School Scoreboard Live coming up here. It's 10:37 right now, and so watch it at 11 o'clock on Fox Sports Southwest. Fox Sports Southwest. I should probably practice talking before I have to do it for 2 hours. Okay, thanks. I love you.